Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by Jason Tebb and Clive Beattie from On The Market. Jason, you've just released some interim results. Could you take us through the headlines?
Yes, we're pleased with these results. We're trading in line with expectations. We've got increased revenue and average revenue per advertiser. And that's as a result of our suite of new and innovative products, some software solutions, and some commercial partnerships as well. We're building on these four core pillars of our strategy, which is portal, software, data, and marketing solutions for our customers, and an eye on consumer opportunities in the long term as well. And building out this suite of products via internal developments and commercial partnerships is progressing really well as we become much more than just a portal. And we released a huge upgrade to the site in September with a whole host of new features and new products for our customers. So we believe that now we've got this suite of tools which offer outstanding value to agents, way more than just the listing service, and potentially saving agents thousands of pounds as well. I'll hand over to Clive maybe to go through the financial headlines.
Thank you, Jason. Yes. So again, we've seen continued revenue growth. Revenues are up 14% and our ARPA, the average revenue per advertiser, up 9% in support of that. Importantly, an area we've touched on in the past, our new homes division, that continues to grow very strongly, both in terms of the developments listed and the increase in the ARPA. And that's contributed to a rise to 1.9 million, up 73% in the period on period comparison. All that has led to continued profitability, an adjusted operating profit of 1.3 million. That's down on last periods, but that's because we've been investing particularly in marketing and in the team for the medium term growth and benefit of the business. But nevertheless, we generated cash of 3.1 million and we ended up in cash at 8.7 million on the balance sheet with no borrowings at the period end. So all that obviously very encouraging. And that was supported by some very strong operational metrics. The average advertisers on the portal grew 1% to just over 13,100. And within that, we saw against the second half of last year, both our visits from consumers and our average leads generated per advertiser, both increasing to 138 million visits and 107 leads per advertiser. So all very encouraging, but particularly actually, I'd like to draw out two or three statistics which we think are showing the direction of travel. Jason has touched on, we want to become more than just a listing site for properties. We want to add value-added services to our customers, but also to consumers in the way that they search. And the things we're particularly pleased with, again, in this period are that we've seen revenues increase from our estate agency customers for additional products over and above the listing agreements, and they've grown 73% in the period. We've seen valuation leads to agents increase by 69%, and those are the most valuable leads, particularly in difficult markets as we're experiencing currently. And then if we look at the consumer side, we've been very pleased to have a very high conversion rate for those consumers visiting the site generating leads. So we have a conversion rate of 6.1% for leads generated from site visits, which we think is very, very high and very strong, and really just underpins the fact that people coming to onthemarket.com are serious property seekers. They're looking to buy or rent or sell or let. They're not just browsing.
So Clive, tell us about the outlook for the rest of the year.
Yeah, so we are very comfortable with the full year expectations at the moment. Our model is not directly linked to transaction numbers or to house prices. We have a subscription-based model where we have contracted revenues on a monthly basis, subscription basis. So really what we have to do is, in any market conditions, but I guess particularly in tough market conditions for our customers, we need to be providing them a value-added service, a valuable service to underpin those revenues that we seek to generate. But actually we're confident that we'll see revenue growth in the second half. And actually that, because we've got a relatively fixed cost base, that should give us increased operating margins in half two. So actually we should see our operating margin improve. We should see our operating profit improve in the second half. We weighted towards that and we're comfortable that, you know, the full year is in line with expectations.
Thanks, Clive. Now, Jason, I wonder if you could just give us a little bit more information about what consumers can expect from the housing market in the coming months. It's obviously a subject a lot of people are focused on at the moment.
Yeah, it's a good question. Of course, there's reports every day about what may or may not happen in the market. Some are reporting that a correction's around the corner. Some are saying the opposite. The simple answer, no one knows for sure. But my personal view, having previously worked as an estate agent for 20 years is that the market is starting to rebalance itself following these really high double-digit growth periods of the previous year. And I think if you look backwards to what we saw in the first half of the year, there were many clear supply and demand fundamentals at play with very few new instructions coming to the market, but hundreds of active buyers. So to some extent, that's been the overriding factor, probably behind the continued growth in the last two quarters as well. But I think there's now signs of more stock coming to the market. Our own data shows that there are more properties on for sale now than at any time since March 21. And with the cost of living rising and the interest rate increases as well, this is naturally going to affect the buying power of those people who are serious property seekers. But we feel there's likely still sufficient unfulfilled demand from all of those buyers who wanted to move over the last couple of years, but simply couldn't find anything suitable. Now there's much more choice for them. And indeed, our latest On the Market Property Sentiment Index supports this, with 75% of our active buyers reporting that they were confident that they'd buy a property in the next 3 months. 79% of sellers were confident they'd sell in the next 3 months. And crucially, 53% of all properties were still going under offer within 30 days of instruction. So we see from our own data that buyer sentiment is still high, and it's usually sentiment that does drive a market as well. I think in terms of the more medium to long term, as mortgage affordability and rising living costs make things more challenging for buyers, there may well be a cooling of house price growth and in some areas a reduction in average house prices. But having said all that, as Clive mentioned earlier, the point to remember is, from On the Market's perspective, our performance isn't directly linked to either housing market activity or transaction numbers, because we have a very simple subscription model. So we're focusing on providing this suite of products that represent exceptional value for money. And we believe that we've got this proposition which supports its customers in any market conditions.
Jason Tebb and Clive Beattie from On the Market, thank you very much for joining us on Proactive.
Thank you.